In 3 minutes, I'm gonna show you how you can reverse engineer the income that you want this year so you can make more money and impact. What's up, it's Danie. I'm so glad you're here. I help entrepreneurs scale personal brands on YouTube. Today, I'm sharing my process for reverse engineering my financial goals, and I've created a worksheet so that you can easily do this as well. Let's head over there.
You were able to make a copy of this worksheet by clicking up above, and I put it in the description box below. So the first thing you're going to do is you're going to write down what are your current offers and incomes. So maybe you have a course or you're a freelance online teacher. Write out all the ways that you pull in money into your business. And then from there, I want you to go into your specific monetary and impact goal. List out what do you want to make this year. We're going to give an example. Let's say you want to hit 6 figures this year. You want to make $100,000. And something important to note with goal setting theory, if it doesn't feel like it's a challenge to you, then you're not going to pursue it. So it needs to feel challenging. Remember that. Then I want you to write how many people you want to work with this year. So let's say you want to work with 60 people and think what's realistic for you to be able to work with however many clients or how many courses do you want to sell? I always like to think of my impact in terms of people that I'm helping. And so that's what I recommend to do. Then from there, write out how many hours you want to be working for. Let's say you have other sources of income, other things you want to sell, write that out as well. And then you're going to start with your fixed or hourly income if you have one. I found that most people do. They have some sort of a side hustle or main income as they're building out their businesses. So let's say for you, you're an online teacher and you want to work 20 hours a week teaching at $25 an hour. That means that you would be making $26,000 a year. So we're going to subtract $26,000 from $100,000. And that's going to mean you're going to need to make $74,000 from other products. I'm going to take $74,000 and I'm going to divide that by the 60 people that I want to be really impacting and working with this year in my business. And that's going to show me that I need to be charging at least $1,200 to be able to meet that goal. And so what does that mean for you? That means you need to create a course or a mastermind or that service that you're providing your business that is worth at least double to triple that amount in value. So if that scares you, if that number scares you to be like, oh my gosh, I couldn't charge people $1,200 to be able to go through my course or my program, then you need to add on value to your program. So when you sell it, you're like, I know this is a great value. It's more than worth this price and you can sell it with confidence. That's so important. So then you've got, let's say your teaching income, your course income, that's going to allow you to hit $100,000. But now we need to break this down. So then I want you to write out every major task needed to complete these goals, right? So maybe that's then opening 5 hours of teaching a week, Monday through Friday. That's creating a masterclass that funnels people into your course. What are all the things that go into that masterclass? Maybe you need to add modules to your course to add value. Write out every single thing that you can possibly think of. And then you're going to break it into quarters. So you're going to take all the things you need to do. And then I'd like for you to name your quarter. So maybe quarter one, know that it's going to take you a little bit of time to kind of build things up. So maybe quarter one is titled building. And so your goal is then I'm going to sign on 10 clients this month and I'm going to run one masterclass and I'm going to blank, blank, and blank. Make it specific and make a date specific. And then write out all the tasks to be able to complete that for that quarter. And then it's important that at the end of each quarter, you kind of reflect back on yourself. Feedback is a huge part of goal setting theory and making sure that you really commit and are able to meet the goals that you set yourself in a year. Make sure you reflect back every quarter. And you can do that for the second quarter and know that quarters will build on themselves. So I know in the past for my business, my first quarter maybe wasn't going to be as strong as my fourth quarter because I'm building up things in my business. So maybe I know that if I had 10 clients in quarter one, by quarter three, I can have more like 20 to 30 clients in this quarter or whatever it may be to be able to hit all my goals. So allowing myself to kind of ease into the numbers that I'm wanting to hit is really important. And then from there, after you set this up into quarters, then you want to have a monthly breakdown of your tasks. All right. So I take everything for that quarter and that first quarter is going to be January, February, March. And I'm going to break it into what do I need to be doing January, February, March. And I set specific dates of everything that I need to be getting done. For you, you may even want to take that a step further and break it into weeks so that you understand what to be doing on a weekly basis to hit that larger monetary and impact goal for your business. The last thing that you need to remember to do to make sure that you hit this goal is share it with somebody. Get an accountability partner and have them watch this video, send them this worksheet, and then you can do your quarterly reviews together and see what are you checking off on your schedule. I can't wait to see what you do this year, and I would love if you fill this out. Make sure you at me on Instagram. I'd love to check it out.
If this was helpful for you, it's so helpful for me if you can give it a thumbs up. Be sure to subscribe, and why wait for next week's video? Be sure to check out these other helpful videos, and I'll see you next time.